Dear student, Assalamu alaikum. I hope by the grace of Almighty Allah, all of you are fine. Dear student, I am Muhammad Shah Jahan, Assistant Professor, Department of Accounting, Milestone College, Uttara, Dhaka. Dear student, today we'll discuss chapter 10, and you know this. This is financial statement. This is our 13th lecture on this chapter, and this will be the last lecture for this chapter. Dear student, at the end of this lecture, you will be able to know about important short question from this chapter. Dear student, let's come to the class. Dear student, final account is divided into 5 parts. Dear student, at the time of theoretical lecture, that means CQ related lecture, we have discussed these things. According to IAS, International Accounting Standard, financial statement, financial account, final account is divided into 5 parts. Dear student, the main objective of income statement, that means out of this 5 part, number 1 is income statement. And in income statement, why we prepare income statement? Dear student, to ascertainment of net profit or net loss of the business. Net profit or net loss of the business. Then balance sheet means, dear student, that means this is another step. Out of this 5, this is another step. And balance sheet, it is British name. In modern word, we can say it financial statement, financial position, statement of financial position. The balance sheet or financial position means, dear student, balance sheet or financial position means statement of liabilities and asset of the business. That means in balance sheet or in financial statement, we show the asset liabilities of the business, asset and liabilities of the business. Income received in advance. That means, dear student, if you receive income in advance, then it is a liability of business. It is a liability of business. To the business, goodwill. Dear student, goodwill is asset. Goodwill is our asset. And outstanding expenses is liabilities and current liability. That means if any expenses is outstanding, you know, dear student, I have earlier discussed current liability. That means the liability which we have to pay within short time. So outstanding expense is our current liability. Look at, if you need to pay the salary of your staff, maybe for 1 month you did not pay for any reason, but you have to pay it immediately. So that is current liability. That means if any expense is outstanding, dues, arrears, then it is our current liability. In the balance sheet, total of asset is always equals to total of liabilities and equity. That means in a balance sheet, whatever asset we have will be equals to liabilities and equities. A businessman can take decision from financial statement. Dear student, financial position is the financial statement, is the final statement of an organization. So from this, any businessman can take decision about his business. Dear student, selling price minus gross profit equals to cost of goods sold. Selling price minus gross profit equals to cost of goods sold. Before preparing final account, we prepare trial balance. Before preparing final account, we prepare trial balance. If interest on drawings is in trial balance, then it will be recorded in income statement. Dear student, this is a controversial item. If interest on invest drawings, dear student, if it is in the adjustment, that time we have to record 2 times. Once in income statement, other in owner's equity statement. But if it is only in trial balance, only in trial balance, then it will be only income statement. So be careful. Dear student, if an outstanding salary is in trial balance, then it will be recorded in balance sheet. If outstanding salary, that means normally if salary in adjustment, we have to add with salary in income statement, then we have to write it in balance sheet. But if it is only in trial balance, then it will be directly balance sheet. Dear student, drawing 15,000, rate of interest 10%. Please take your calculator, then you can understand. Drawings is 15,000, rate of interest, that means 15,000 into 10. Divide by 100. Dear student, of course it is 1500. It is 1500, but in average method. That's why in average method, the interest will be 50%. That means half. So 1500 into 1 divided by 2. That means half. It is 750 taka interest on drawings. Apprentice premium is income, other income. It is other income of a business. Patent, trademark, goodwill, invisible asset. That means this is our asset, this is our fixed asset, but we cannot see. Patent, trademark, and goodwill, invisible asset. Prepaid expenses, this is also an asset. Look at it is expense, but asset. Why? Because it is prepaid. We paid in advance. Next year we can use, we can get benefit from this expense. That's why it is asset. For which concept anticipated loss is shown in account, but anticipated income is not shown in account. That means if there is any probability of loss, we have to show it in the account, but if there is any probability of gain or income, it we cannot show it. It is conservatism. It is conservatism concept. Dear student, according to IAS, the number one MCQ, same MCQ repeat, IAS 1, we have to decide financial statement into, divide the financial statement into how many parts? Dear student, 5 parts. That means IAS 1. IAS 1, most important. This is MCQ can be reversed. According to who is IAS? The financial statement is divided into 5 parts. Answer will be IAS 1. IAS 1. So, keep it in mind. Dear student, IAS 1. IAS, International Accounting Standard. So, here we can see 3 MCQ. IAS means International Accounting Standard. And how many part? It is 5 part. And for which IAS financial statement is 5 part? It is IAS 1. Which type of income and expenditure are recorded in the statement of comprehensive income? Revenue. Dear student, only revenue income are recorded in income statement. Revenue income and revenue expenses are recorded in comprehensive income statement. Which type of organization do not involve in trading? Dear student, you know that there are two types of organization, trading concern and service providing organization. So, trading concern has involved with trading, they are buying and selling goods, but in service organization, they are not buying or selling any types of goods, they are providing service. Net profit can be ascertained through deduction of cost of service from income. Net profit, how we can find out the net profit? Cost of service from income, that means what about the revenue we have, we have to subtract the cost of for that revenue, then we will get the net profit. From which net profit and loss can be known? Comprehensive income statement. Dear student, from comprehensive income statement we know the net profit or loss. For a trading concern, main source of income is sales. Dear student, for a trading concern, main source of income is sales. Earning from share is known as dividend. Earning from share is known as dividend. Dear student, if we invest any company's share, then the earning is called dividend. The statement of changes in equity is prepared to ascertain closing balance of owner's equity. Closing balance of owner's equity. To find out the equity, we have to prepare a statement of changes of equity. Dear student, asset and liabilities are arranged generally in liquidity preference method. That means at first liquid asset, then fixed asset. Dear student, asset and liabilities are arranged. That means at the time of preparing financial position or balance sheet, at first you have to write the liquid, most liquid asset, then investment, then fixed asset. On the other hand, we can arrange it fixed asset, then investment, then current asset also. Dear student, what is the other name of invested capital? It is capital employed. It is capital employed. What is fixed asset? Fixed asset is those which are used in business for long time. That means the asset which we used in the business for long time, that is fixed asset. This type of asset is not bought for selling purpose. Dear student, what is current asset? Current asset are those assets which can be converted into cash within accounting period. That means within short time we can convert it into a cash. What is long term liabilities? What is long term liability? Dear student, long term liabilities are liabilities which are taken for long period of time is called long term liabilities. Then like loan, debenture, bond, this is the long term liabilities. That means we need not to pay within short time, we have to pay it long period, after long period. Under which concept the business is separate from the its proprietors? It is business entity concept. Business entity concept says that owners and business are not same. Dear student, the income and expenditure are divided into capital and revenue.